If you know me, you know that I'm a huge fan of attachment theory. John Bowlby is the father of attachment theory. He said this: all of us from cradle to grave are happiest when life is organized as a series of excursions, long or short, from the secure base provided by our attachment figures. Another way, or another time, he paraphrased that same thought in saying, life is best organized as a series of daring ventures from a secure base. And so the very name of my practice comes from a John Bowlby quote, daring ventures. The idea is that if I am in a securely attached relationship, if I have another person with whom I am securely attached so that I know that I can count on their presence, I can count on their affirmation, I can count on their support, I can count on them being accessible and responsive to me, then I have the courage to have daring ventures, to venture out, to live a full life, to take healthy, appropriate risks that move me forward in my own development. I can do that because I have the safe harbor of a secure attachment relationship to go back to eventually. But we got to start with understanding the basics of attachment, this idea of attachment. I'm a Christian, and so when I read the Bible, I see attachment all over the place. From the very beginning, God creates human beings in his image, male and female. He created them in his image. Let us create them in our image, it says in Genesis 1. As a Christian, I read that as the God of the Christian faith, the triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, creating us in his image. He exists as relationship. And so when he made that first human and saw that he was alone, he said, it is not good. That was the first not good in the whole Bible, was that a human made in the image of God was alone. And so he made one who was like him, of the same essence and of the same character, one and yet different. And so I just see it all over. We see it, though. You don't have to be a person of faith or a Christian to see the importance of connection.